This video, I'm going to be sharing with you the secrets of your higher self. It's time you know these things. These are things that once you know, will also speed up the process of you achieving your goals. Welcome back to another video. My name's Aaron, and I help people expand their consciousness. Now, in this video, I'm going to be sharing with you that of the secrets. All right, welcome back to another video. My name is Aaron, and I help people expand their consciousness. Now, in this video, I'm going to be sharing with you that of understanding the secrets of your higher self when it comes to manifestation. And this has to do with understanding really who you are. When you tap into the awareness of who you really are, it makes manifestation easier because then you start to use another facet that maybe you haven't been using. Sometimes we think it's all the ego. The ego has to do everything. That was me for a very long time. But even now as I go, I'm learning to let go a little bit more, not have to put everything in its place and make sure everything happens. And it's, let me tell you, be honest with you, it's been a lot easier. It's been so much easier because I realize that I don't have to do absolutely everything. There are parts when I can just let go, when I can get into the right energy state and focus on that, and then knowing that my higher self has it taken care of. Now, some of the things I'm going to share with you in this video are going to be a little bit more esoteric. I'm going to be honest with you, just throw it out there right now. It's a little bit more esoteric. But there are things that when you know, it changes everything. You see the world differently, you see your life differently, because you realize that you are not just the ego. And that's one of the purposes of life too. One of the purposes of life is to wake up to who you really are. Your ego is a structure, is a, think of it like an avatar that you would use in a way kind of like a video game. You know, you might play the game Sims and you're like, oh, this is what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go take the kids to school, and then I'm gonna come back and eat my Wheaties or whatever it is. That's something you could do with the game The Sims. In the same way, you know that you aren't just the character. You know that there's more to it than you just being that little avatar character. In the same way, you come from a higher dimensional level of consciousness. You are unconditional love and bliss. You come to Earth to learn, to experience things a little bit slower, because in your natural habitat, like where you're from, things happen instantaneously. You think of something, it appears. So you come to Earth and you're kind of shocked. You're like, normally I would just think this and something would come, but now I gotta think it and I gotta keep thinking it, or I gotta do this or I gotta do that. Whereas normally there's no time and space in the same way. You see, you and your higher self, you as your higher self in the higher dimensional levels of consciousness, things happen almost instantaneously because there's not, it's not bound by time and space as much. Maybe there's certain realities that are, but from your higher self, the higher self is like, think of it like the, not necessarily as more connected than you, but the higher self is still a part of you. It is the part of you that's just more aware, more awake, higher vibrational in nature. And your higher self is you and is also guiding you through your life. And when you go through certain experiences in your life, things may happen that may have been set up by your higher self. Now, you're not at the victim of your higher self because your higher self is also you. So it's things that you at a greater level have decided upon to have certain type of experiences. Now, here's something that's a little bit more esoteric that I haven't shared before. But think of it like this. In a way, there's different levels to this experience that we call, you know, life on Earth. You at nighttime are waking up to higher levels of consciousness. You go through a veil of forgetfulness. You forget that this is what you do every single night when you go to bed. You are connecting to different levels of consciousness. When you go to bed every night, you are existing in those higher dimensional states of consciousness. And you may be also planning out certain scenarios, certain opportunities that are coming into your life. So for example, there may be certain appointments you've made, certain soul contracts you've made, certain things you want to learn. Because Earth is like a school. It's learning going on here. And one of the big learning lessons of the society, of the planet right now, is waking up. That may have been something that you set for you to do. And maybe you're waking up right now. And my guess is that if you're even perceiving of this video, that you are already in the process of it. Because you cannot perceive that which you are not the vibration of. If you hear me say this right now, then you are also in that process, have gone through that process, or will go through that process. But know that this is part of something you signed up for. Now, when you go to bed every night, your higher self is in a way there with you. Even though it is you, this gets a little bit complicated because we think in terms of what we identify as our structure, right? We interpret our reality through the five senses: see, hear, touch, smell, taste. So when we think of this, we think, well, how can I be here and there at the same time? This does not compute. But it's about knowing that we're so much more than just this physical structure. We are more than just our physical body. We may interpret reality through our five senses, but we actually go beyond our five senses. It's not so much that we are in our body, it's more that our body is within us. We are our consciousness. Think of us as consciousness. Just like we might be the drop in the ocean, we are also the ocean in the drop. This is something that when we begin to absorb, can change our whole entire life. Now, what we do when we go to bed at night, and at different levels of consciousness, is we pre-plan certain things we want to have. Now, this is what's kind of cool about the higher self. Look at it from the higher self's perspective. They have kind of a cool job. Now, they are also us, so this is why it's like we're just using these labels and everything. But our higher self is like, okay, this is Aaron's belief system. Aaron believes this. Aaron goes through the daily activities of this. Aaron keeps on doing this, but we want to show him a lesson. You're going to punish me or anything, but we want to show him some stuff that will help him to learn this quicker, because then he's going to take that with him and it's going to allow him to go on a certain energy track. Think of it like this. There's an infinite number of parallel realities that exist. There's certain choices that if our higher self can guide us through, will put us on different tracks, different things that we want to experience. So, for example, there may be something I want to learn at a certain level. Maybe my ego doesn't necessarily want to learn it, but that of the higher self is going to help guide me to certain situations. For example, something that I might be going through right now is I work like 16 hours a day because I love what I do. I get up every day, I make videos, I go, I edit those videos, I do all this business stuff, important business stuff online where I get to feel real important, and I like doing it, and I'm passionate about it. However, at the same time, since I've been full-time on YouTube since August 2017, I have worked every single day for about 12 to 14 hours a day. I hardly take a day off. I make a video every single day, no matter what. So part of me is, this is what I'm passionate about. I justify it because I love to do it. But what a message I've been getting from my higher self lately is, bro, chill a little bit. Enjoy the human experience. Enjoy being and doing what you're doing on earth. Enjoy this stuff. Have fun. And my ego's kind of like, no, success. I got to get to this next level. Ooh, there's this level. I want to get to a million of this. It's all of this. Kind of the ego desires. So what is my higher self doing? I'm going to bed at night, higher self's like, look, you could be doing this, this, and this, and this is great, but why don't you enjoy yourself, dude? Just have a little bit of fun, bro. And then what I do is I wake up and I go through certain experiences. Now, there may be certain type of little things that could happen that my higher self helped orchestrate. Could be someone coming into my life, could be certain opportunities, could be some type of whatever. And when it comes into my life, if I take not the bait, but if I take it and go along with it, then it puts me on a certain energy track, and then I'm able to let go. I'm able to change my belief. Maybe I have a belief. Maybe somehow I have a belief that I have to attain a certain level of something before I can feel happy. And I am becoming aware that, yo, you can be happy now. By being happy now, you'll actually become successful quicker or even more successful, whatever it is. So that's the idea. The idea is there's certain little, almost like a carrot on a stick that the higher self may be showing my ego self, and I can follow that. If I follow that, things will get easier. Now, if I don't follow that, maybe it gets a little bit harder. Maybe I start creating more resistance, and then that manifests with like more and more people that something happens, or I have to take time away because something happens, and there's a situation. So the idea is that we can learn as we go, but understand that this isn't like the higher self versus us. The higher self is us. It's guiding us through this process. And if we trust the higher self more, we will then create what we want easier than ever. That is the key, trusting the higher self, because the higher self is you. It's just that in our ego understanding, we like to separate things, right? I'm Aaron Dowdy on YouTube. This is this person. This is this person. We're all individual, different people. At a greater level of consciousness, we are all connected though. We think our energy field ends at our fingertips. It goes far beyond, and when we go into public, we are literally immersed in each other's energy fields. So this is about having awareness. There's so much more going on than we think. But in general, we are our higher selves. And in this lifetime right now, one of the things that we agreed to was that we would go through a transformation of consciousness. That we would go through this transformation of becoming more aware of who we are, waking up from this dream of life and merging with our higher self. You see, our higher self is the higher vibrational aspect of us. And in order for us to really merge with it, we have to let go of some things that no longer serve. I had to let go of my painful past. I had to become aware of the beliefs I had that were holding me back. I'm still letting go of some beliefs that don't serve me. So, knowing this though, the one thing that I really have felt since 2011 when I went through my spiritual awakening is that now on the planet is a time of transformation. And if you read Dolores Cannon's books, there's 17 books of transcripts of people that were in what is called this deep level of hypnosis that was by a technique that's called QHHT, Quantum Healing Hypnosis Technique. Thousands and thousands and thousands of people have been under in this hypnosis state, and their higher selves and their subconscious mind comes through and will give information. And through thousands of people all over the world, when you ask and say, why are you here right now? Why did you incarnate? Why did you have this experience with your mom and your dad and all this painful stuff? Well, this is learning, or was this, or was that, or was, you know, getting, you know, whatever it was. You know what so many people, thousands of people have said? They are here right now on the planet, because right now on the planet, it is the most exciting time to ever be alive, because there is a transformation of consciousness happening at a global scale. This is happening at a global scale where more and more people are waking up. Doesn't mean that I look around and I'm saying everyone's enlightened, Buddha is just walking around everywhere. I understand that you could say, Aaron, what are you talking about? Look on the news and the media. There's stuff going on. What do you mean? I'm talking about levels of consciousness. And the idea is that somebody that is at a certain level of consciousness, maybe that of a 400 to 500 level of consciousness on that scale that I always share that goes from 0 to 1,000, somebody at the mid to higher levels, just maybe 100 people could influence millions or billions of people when you're at a certain level of consciousness. So as we wake up, if you're watching this video, you are one of those people that has the potential to really transform your consciousness. And everyone has the potential to do it. But the idea is that you only perceive that which you are the vibration of. And if you hear this right now, then most likely that's where you are as well. Now, the idea is that we knew that this was part of our life experience, was to go through this transformation of consciousness. To remember who we are, to remember that we are immortal spiritual beings living temporary human experiences, to remember that we are multidimensional. That's where I get a little bit esoteric. Multidimensional. You think, I'm Aaron, this is who I am. At nighttime, I'm going doing different things, but you don't remember it. You do the same thing. I'm not saying I'm special because I'm Aaron. I'm saying you also are doing the same thing. You go to bed at night, you are awake in higher states of consciousness. But there's a veil that you don't remember when you wake up in the morning, because if you remembered that you were unconditional love and bliss and that you existed in a very magical type place that wasn't bound by time and space, it kind of rhymed, but if you knew that, you would wake up in the morning, and if you're going through some hard stuff, you'd be like, why am I here? I don't want to be here. I want to wake up in the divine whatever, in the higher dimensions. So what happens is we are shielded out of protection, out of knowing that we have a purpose for being here, and it may not serve our purpose if we knew all of what was going on in the higher dimensions. So in a way, we kind of forget that. Just like if you were playing a video game, if you were playing Grand Theft Auto, and you were going around causing havoc, and you had cheat codes and everything, and you knew it was a game, you would treat it very differently than if you went in and you knew, okay, I can't go over here, I can't hit this lady and then grab this and then beat up this dude with a bat and then go and get in a car and steal this or steal. Like, when you know that you can't do all that, then what happens is you take it much more seriously. And that's part of the purpose of life, is for us to remember. The paradox is it's to remember that that's who we are anyways. We are the higher self. That this is a form of game. This is a form of simulation. But at a higher level of consciousness, we are unconditional love and bliss. And just now, in life, we are becoming more aware of this. Now, here is something else. As the vibration continues to raise on the planet, manifestation will happen quicker and quicker and quicker. It is about you aligning with that vibrational state. It is about letting go of what doesn't serve. Letting go of the need to control even. Allow things to happen in your life. This is where the Eastern philosophy of letting go mixes with the Western thought of control your reality. So about control. Understand also, infinite number of parallel realities that exist. You're choosing them, not controlling them. They already exist. You don't have to create your own reality because that reality already exists. All you have to do is make the choices. Make the choices, allow, let go, go on that life track. Understand that it's so much easier than you thought. Things are orchestrated by your higher self. And if you trust it, you will then allow more of it to flow through. But if you think that you have to do everything, you have to control every little aspect of it, then in a way, you keep yourself in a little bit of a box. You keep yourself restricted to where it's like there's not much you can do because you think that there has to be a certain way of going about it. Allow things to happen, open up the possibilities and the potentialities of what could happen, and then trust the process, and you'll see that things happen even easier. But this is about having that level of awareness. So understand that this life on earth is about merging with our higher selves. And then as you merge into a higher level of consciousness, you will manifest things easier than ever because you're existing in a higher vibration. You always experience a reality that is equal to your vibration. If you're feeling these undertones in your vibration of shame, fear, guilt, and anger, then you will continue to create experiences in your life that mirror that level of vibration. However, if you understand that you can let go of that and you can merge with your higher self, because all of that ego stuff was something that you just have to integrate, complete the experience and let it go. If you understand that, then everything begins to change. Now, something that I do have as well is if you want to learn how to complete the past, this is how you transform to literally living as the higher self. I have a free meditation. You'll see it's another YouTube video. It's in the top of the description box on the completion meditation. This will help you to complete the past so you don't have to repeat the past. What you don't complete, you repeat. And you let go of these lower vibrational emotions, everything begins to change. You start to experience a reality that is equal to how you prefer to be. So it's one of the most powerful meditations I've ever made. It's about a 30-minute long meditation once you get to the meditation part of the video. It's in the top description box below. Complete the past and watch how your life transforms. So I recommend you listen to that for 21 days to get the maximum benefit out of it. You'll see it in the top of the description box below. Know that you are your higher self, that you are merging with your higher self right now, that over the next 10, 15, 20 years, there is a consciousness shift happening on the planet. It will continue to happen. Manifestation will continue to speed up. You will notice that what you think comes to fruition much quicker than ever, both the good and the bad. The key is to get in alignment with this higher vibration, because when you are in alignment, things happen even better for you, and it's a higher vibration. So it's a win-win. So I will also be doing more live Q&As on Instagram. So if you want to ask me questions, if you want to interact with me there, Instagram is right here. I also post daily content there as well, twice a day, normally videos. If you want native content as well, Instagram right there. Other than that, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you could do this as well, the way YouTube does things now is you actually have to hit the notification bell to see my daily videos. Some people say, hey, I'm subscribed to you, but I don't see all the videos that you do. I'm missing videos. Hit the notification bell. You hit the notification bell, you will see the daily videos. I have a lot of good stuff coming. We're going to be getting a little bit more esoteric. Hit that below. Like this video if you liked it. Subscribe if you haven't already. Other than that, as always, peace, much love, namaste.